again, everybody, from Ashland High School. It's Ashland High School Varsity Sports on WACA-TV. Tonight, the Ashland Public Schools and the Tri-Valley League present boys varsity basketball with the Ashland High School Clockers hosting a non-league team tonight, Bob, the Hopedale Blue Raiders.
Blue Raiders, yeah. And they're wearing the Duke uniforms, the black and blue and white.
They're pretty close to us, huh?
Yeah.
The blue is a little darker, I'd say.
Yeah. We got the home whites on, so it's like a Duke scrimmage tonight.
You know, they were the Central Mass champs last year, I find out.
Yeah, they had a great run, both girls and boys. They had I forget the young lady's name, but she was a terrific individual basketball player. But the boys team, who didn't get a lot of the ink, wound up winning the Central Mass championship.
And I know we played last year, and what I gather, they beat us in a pretty tough game.
Yeah.
And they're undefeated this year, 3-0.
Well, I don't know if you've ever been to that Draper Gym in Hopedale, Bob, but it's a classic little gym. The stage in the front of the gym, multi-purpose kind of place. That was, it's an old mill town, and a lot of the things that still exist there, buildings and houses and school facilities, were all built when the company was rocking and rolling. They were building looms in Hopedale. So it's one of those gyms you walk in and you're back in the 50s. It's like Hoosiers. It's a tough place to win. I think it probably seats 36 people.
That Draper building's still there.
It is still there, yeah.
Mammoth.
Yeah, the plant is shut, but the building's still there. And now we'll pause for the national anthem.
Clockers haven't played since we last saw them when they had a rather gritty comeback win over the Millis Mohawks here at Ashland High School. I thought the team showed a lot of heart and a lot of poise
lot of
in coming
tenacity.
Back and taking that game.
It was one of those games where you just hope that the clock didn't run out before the Clockers made their comeback, and they did. They hung in there and played tough down the stretch. Max Feinberg just lit it up from the free throw line. And that was enough at the end to get the clock. Cause I think it was a 5-point win, Bob.
Thereabouts. When all was said and done, yeah.
Yep. Yeah.
But a barn burner.
But a barn burner, back and forth, and they didn't really have a lead till late in that game. This is a tenacious group. I was looking at the boys. They got six that are all about 6'2" and six that are all about 5'10". No real huge kids, no real small kids. Hopedale about the same look. Got a couple of boys with some height. And their coach is a gentleman named Cordani. I don't know if he's related to the Milford Cordanis of baseball fame, but if they are, that's a rich athletic tradition.
I spoke with Coach Cordani before the game. Told me he's got everyone back from his Central Mass champions.
Well, that helps, doesn't it? You become a much better coach when everybody's back.
Clockers go right to the rim.
Nice put back there by Boudreaux. Mike Boudreaux. On a missed shot by Max, but good rebounding underneath.
Clockers are going to have their hands full with this group tonight, so they better get off to a good start.
Kevin Lynch. Ashland, if they had one deficiency in that Millis game, Bob, it was getting back on the break. That was hopefully not a portent of things to come.
Another layup.
John Van Cleef
returns to the lineup after injury and gets a the starting nod and a basket in his first minute.
Yeah, very solid player.
The point guard looks to be number 5, Kevin Bresciani. He's the captain of the Blue Raiders, who look almost black. I guess they're wearing black uniforms, right?
Well, the trim is blue. That's about it.
Yeah, those little lines on the sides are blue. But
could they be the black and blue Raiders? Well,
they look like Bellingham. There he is, the leading scorer. Beats the buzzer.
Clock running out.
His name is Luke Cowan. On Cowan, Boudreau, and one!
Nice finish there by Paul Boudreau. Draws the foul, hangs, and makes the basket.
No shots?
Yeah, he'll get a shot. Oh, wow. They didn't call a foul on?
Did I miss something?
Wait a minute. They called a foul on no basket? Yep. And they gave the ball to Hopedale? I don't get that. I don't get that play.
Do we already have those 4 points?
Maybe called the.
Do we already have those four
apparently
points?
Apparently, he called an offensive on Paul Boudreau. Yeah,
what,
we did
after
have
the shot?
Must have been, because he didn't give him the basket.
Oh, they didn't?
No.
Okay. Offensive foul.
How about that?
Yeah, you don't see it too often.
I thought it was on the other 34.
Here's a collision. Van Cleef survives it, but loses the ball. And here comes Kevin Bresciani. Into the lane, up, and too much mustard on that one. Cam Faniff with the board. And number 4 is Max Feinberg, leading scorer for the Clockers. Faniff is 33. Paul Boudreau is 34. Mike Boudreau is 22. And 32 is John Van Cleef.
Yeah, John, a little hot before he put that ball up.
Clockers have had great chances, Bob.
They really have.
Should have more than 4 points.
So
4-2.
Well, Hopedale's had 4 shots already, and 3 of them layup variety. You only get 2 points.
Bresciani, number 13, is Kevin Lynch. Who was that for? Oh, yeah, there he is. He was in the back there. I didn't see him. Trying to thread it to Sam Lawrence, number 2. Cam is fouled.
Now, I'm not going to write anything down until I hear what the call is.
You almost never see that offensive foul into the basket,
no.
Bob.
No.
And then they used to have that crazy rule where the basket would count and then the offensive foul would bring it, you know.
Yeah.
Because the ball theoretically was let go before the contact, and they did away with that.
There's some logic to that, but
that was in college. That was done away with. And yeah. Does the NBA have like some kind of a circle?
Yeah, now they have a no-fly zone.
Yeah, you're right. Yeah. Under the basket.
Can't fit if I missed both of those. Ashton's had
some Feinberg on Bresciani, coast to coast. They wouldn't let him have it.
Up the gut, and he draws the blocking ball.
Faniff and Van Cleef combining to knock him down.
Van Cleef, the fortunate
Coach
recipient of that.
Coach is going to have an early sub here, Bob.
He's
going to put in 2 guys.
Yeah.
Who is it? He wants Francis LeBega into the game.
Yeah.
And he wants Mitch Porter. He's bringing in the football team.
Yeah, he's bringing in the physicality. Kevin Bresciani, his first points.
LeBega and Porter outstanding on the football team this season.
Yeah, Francis, this is the second.
Oh, they out-muscled for the board. Oh, this kid wants to shoot. No. Lynch feeling it tonight, but nothing going for him.
He's obviously going to be their 3-point shooter.
Ashton loses it out of bounds.
Got a nice-looking shot from outside. Nothing's gone down yet.
Kevin Lynch is going to inbound it. Bresciani back to Lynch, and they reset well beyond the arc. Bresciani, the point guard, trying to make something happen.
Ashton playing a man defense.
Sam Lawrence is number 2, and number 22 is William Leakey.
Bill Leakey, he's had a couple of trips to the hoop.
And, no.
He gets up there. He's quick. He just has a little trouble finishing. Everybody has so far.
And let's see the Raiders make their first sub. Or who's it going to be? It's 21, Kevin. Oh, boy. Stupiello. High dribble. Controls it, Michael to Francis, into Cam, back to Mike. Oh, heavy pressure. He's open. He doesn't take it. Now he does he isn't open.
Contact there, no call.
Cam over the back, no call, and it's Blue Raider ball when all is said and done.
They're letting him play. 4-3, might as well.
Backcourt pressure. Across the 10-second line it goes. Bresciani, who's this? That's Lynch. Scupiello took that extra step.
Yeah. Little Steven Scupiello.
He was wondering why the path was so clear to that hoop.
If you get a running start, it helps.
Well.
You know, that's one of those things. Max used to do that when he was a bit younger, and he's fixed that problem. Remember, he used to get that little jump step. He used to call three or four times a game.
Many young players, right, Bob?
Yeah, not anymore.
Many young players do it. Get another sub for the Clockers. It's Spencer Rabideau, 21. Into Porter, stuffed, gets it back. Too strong. A hard.
That's a travel.
It was
a foul.
Travel. Wow.
Spencer.
Spencer leveled that boy, and as he was rolling around on the floor. Yeah.
That's why you put the
writhing,
football players
writhing
in.
Writhing in agony. The
good
travel was called on him. Rabideau has it at the arc, wants to go base. Might be a slippery spot there.
How about that?
Stays white. Clockers in their home whites. Hopedale in their visiting black and blue.
Not the most artistic start to our game, Bob. Half the first period gone.
Who was that to?
Max made that pass.
To the rear of a boy? Or?
Yeah, just as Mitch Porter turned away.
Interesting. Still 4-3.
Whoever gets it in second gear first, I think, will create a little differential.
I don't know. More subs.
Trying to find the right combination.
Rossiani's coming out, the point guy. Let's see who takes over.
A little man press right now with a center fielder, Francis Luvega, playing deep. Otherwise, we're matched up.
Well, with the Blue Raiders point guard on the bench, this is the time, I guess, Bob.
Yeah.
Almost they double them, they trap them. Raiders moving around well, but they've lost half their shot clock.
Good press.
Who was that to? No one.
And everybody's doing the same thing, throwing it as the players are turning away. Might have watched the Patriots-Bills game yesterday, Bob.
Yes. Max stripped. Lynch to the basket, give him two. So Kevin...
Luke Cowan.
The leading scorer gets his first basket of the game, only the second basket for Hopedale. But they have a 5-4 lead. Underneath, he sneaks in. Very pretty. Give that to Sam Lawrence.
Yeah. All of a sudden, Hopedale's finding the bottom of the net.
Sam Lawrence picking up the defense. He's everywhere. There's a chance for Michael Boudreau. Looking up. Stupiello. 15 into the game is Brian Espinay. Stupiello off the back of his leg. Kevin Lynch too deep. A bump?
Yeah, I called Francis with that hand check. He had a hand in his hip, a little too forceful. One of the penalties of being strong sometimes, Bob.
Don't know my own strength.
Yeah, he had left hand, he got a little bit of motion.
Luke Cowan is 24, actually. Kevin Lynch turns out to be 13.
Yeah. Cowan's the outside shooter, which.
Yeah.
If it was Dave Cowan, he wouldn't be very happy.
Cowan, very active. Stupiello. Mike's got it.
Off the back
iron. Boudreau between the legs. Crosses it, pushes off. Good defense by Steve Stupiello. Who's got it? Michael, forearm shiver.
Nice fight for the rebound there. Ashland taking care of the offensive glass. Still only 4 points with 6 minutes played.
Brian Espinay seemed a little upset there, number 15.
Yeah, a little contact.
That was a vicious forearm. Seven to four, Bob.
You're going to take him out and give him a little rest. Yeah, 7-4.
Ashland's still on four. Been on four for a good 5 minutes. Up. Cam can't get it to go. Nice rebound.
Leaky, yeah.
By Leaky. He's a good rebounder.
Yeah, that's his strength, obviously. He's offensively challenged.
Bresciani back into the game, picks up the blocking foul.
So he looked like Mike Boudreau was fixed and planted, but.
Kevin Bresciani is determined.
John Van Cleef, excuse me.
He's determined, the captain of the Blue Rays, determined to get to that hoop, but boy, it's been clogged in that lane.
Good things happen when you're aggressive. Kevin, 1-for-3 from the line.
Max returns. Van Cleef exits.
Yeah, John has two fouls, so protecting him in the first half. Bresciani. He's 2-for-4 from the stripe, and Hopedale's doubled up Ashland at 8-4, Barney.
Garrett Fishlock.
Little press here, man.
35 into the game. Max.
Max going to beat it off the dribble.
He's had a nice rest.
Spencer. Spencer being attacked. No call.
Zanuff was open. Could have taken it, but decided to drive and got it slapped away, or did he get fouled?
Hopedale team is very aggressive with their hands, Bob. They're quick, but they also are not afraid to foul. They've got only four team fouls.
Oh, on the cut to Feinberg. He doesn't get it, but he'll shoot two.
Good patience on that inbound pass, but no good result. I'll tell you, Max anticipating the contact. He needs to absorb the contact but finish the play. That was an easy one for him. He's pretty strong physically, so.
Looks like Coach Champagne is going to try two more players.
There's Max's first point of the game with 1:21 left in the first period, and he needs to shoulder some of the scoring burden for this team.
A new player for Ashland is Christian Van Cleef, number 11. Paul Boudreau also returns. Paul's wearing 34.
Yep, like we said, couple sets of twins on this Ashland team.
Max one of two.
Nice hustle.
Van Cleef tried to get it to Faniff and didn't work out. Lynch strong to the hoop, blocked. Out of bounds, Raider ball.
Now Mike Boudreau on one end with a nice offensive rebound and a good rush to the basket that time by Kevin Lynch. Good defensive get back by Ashland.
Underneath, on the cut, he didn't get it to go. Sam Lawrence had a great opportunity.
Yeah, and as happens often, Bob, when you miss the easy basket, over-aggressive, and he reaches in, gets the foul. That's now six on Hopedale.
Jeez,
1-11 left in the first period. There's going to be a lot of shooting and free throws.
Yeah, Ashland's got five team fouls themselves.
Yeah, you better be deep.
Full court trapping, backcourt pressure. A boy goes down hard, and the whistle blows. We're not sure if a foul has been called.
I don't think so. I think it's just a down.
It's Kevin Bresciani.
Cam Faniff at the same place at the same time as Bresciani.
There is a foul.
Really?
Who'd they give it to? They gave it to Paul Boudreau? Huh. We didn't see it.
It wasn't even
away
the play.
From the ball.
Why was that a foul? I'm not sure. And so is Mark Champagne. Not sure.
Oh, you've shuffled those feet.
Another quick step.
Luke Cowan
with that first step. He's quick enough, he doesn't need to get a head start.
Boudreau across the midcourt.
Nice little crossover there. Good patience on that dribble.
Faniff finds Mike. Mike's got good position and makes the play.
There you go.
8-7, clock is trail one. We're in the final 40 seconds of period number one.
Nice move there by Mike Boudreau against his strong hand, Bobby. Pivoted away from his strong hand.
Ashland Hopedale at the Ashland High School gym. underneath. He couldn't get it.
He's just not that player, apparently.
Max Feinberg clears.
Good position. Nice drop step. Wide open finish. Couldn't put it down.
Max pressed deep by Lynch. Guarded closely by Lynch. Bad pass, and the Clockers lose it.
Yeah, Kim trying to force it to Max, and hey, if it isn't there, it isn't there. 8-7, Hopedale. Low scoring first period. A lot of shooting, but low scoring, boy. A lot of fouls.
Bresciani keeps trying, Bob. Keeps trying.
Going to the hoop.
That time he just loses it.
Yeah, that was pinned against his leg, and he kicked it out of bounds. Ashley and ball.
Good defense. Tough pass. Max tracks it down. Oh, he got a foul.
Bresciani pushes him out of bounds.
That was Bresciani just had to do nothing, and that was going to be Hopedale ball.
Yeah. Might be a frustration.
It was like there. A fly pattern, according to the guy throwing it in, right?
He the sideline is your friend.
He just led him.
I think Kevin was a little frustrated. He didn't get the call down the other end. The ball was out off of him and had a chance to whack Max and did.
Max ties the game with just a second and a half left in this first period. This is the second, and that's going to do it. We've played one, and it's Ashland 8 and Hopedale 8. Not a good first period, Bob.
No, I didn't track shots, Bob, but the percentages would be disappointing for both teams. And not because they were bombs away. They were missing layups.
Two long threes did not go early for Hopedale. I don't think Ashland took any.
No threes, but...
Yeah, and everything else was missed layups or... Ball's just thrown away.
Unforced errors.
Yes.
And if you look at the team fouls, Hopedale with 7, Ashland with 6. As we end the first period, we'll be seeing a continual march to the free throw line. And maybe some attrition in this game, too. So far, Paul Boudreau has 2. John Van Cleef has 2. Nobody for Hopedale has more than 1. But still, 7 team fouls.
The free throw situation for non-shooting fouls. They will be one-on-ones. Until the teams reach 10, and then they become 2-shot fouls. Until they reach 10 fouls in a half. Second half, we start the count over again.
Vacation week, Bob. Gym's pretty well packed with kids.
Yeah, they got a good
turnout for a 5:30 game.
They got a good student section.
Excellent.
It's free admission for the holidays, courtesy of the Ashland High School Athletic Department, headed by Ryan Quigley, a new father.
Ah, congratulations. Boy or girl, do we know?
It's a boy.
It's a boy.
Can't remember the name right now.
Robert's a nice name.
What a name.
You and I would like that.
What a name. I've been trying.
You have to do it yourself.
To get some baby named Robert. Good pass. Wow. I don't know how we thread that one,
yeah,
Bob.
Nice look, nice finish. Once he beat the defender.
Clark has had that fronted, but somehow it just around the corner.
Yeah, inches. A lot of contact. Bresciani, very aggressive, but getting away with it. He's only got 1 foul.
That's Mitchell Porter. Deflected to Max. The pull-up jumper in and out. Faniff had it, got it taken away. 2 hands, I guess, Bob. Bresciani against Porter, and Porter right with him every step. Not too much contact, no. But enough for that official at least.
Mitch reached, and that's 7th on Ashland, so we start the parade to the free throw line.
Keep your hands at the ball, then you can get away with the body sometimes.
You can. You have to use the body. They always catch that hand foul.
Bresciani front rims that. Max Feinberg, one-on-one. Coast to coast, Dipsy Doo doesn't go. Fouls on Ashland.
Max a little frustrated
right
now.
We're gonna shoot. Free throws, one-on-one coming up for the Blue Raiders in black tonight. Looking not unlike the Bellingham Blackhawks.
No, quite a bit. Interesting, though. Max, usually reliable, got to the rim. Maybe he was wrong-footed or something, but he...
Something went wrong.
He didn't get it up and over the rim.
Underneath shot was so unnecessary.
Uncharacteristic of him.
Just a straight layup. The defender didn't even foul.
No, it was clear
path. He's going to let him have it.
Bill Leakey, his first point of the game.
Bill's worked hard, but that's his offense so far tonight.
And Hopedale pushes the lead up to 4. Half the total they made in this.
Faniff on the cut to Feinberg. He couldn't get it to go. Mike Boudreau could have got hurt on that play, but as they undercut him a little bit, started heading backwards.
Young and flexible, that helps.
And Mike's going to get the one-and-one opportunity. One-and-one means you make the first, you get the second. You miss the first, the ball's alive. Like that. They step in front of Mike and get the rebound, but Lynch lost his footing and lost the ball out of bounds. White ball. Clock is trailing by 4. Second period action at Ashland High School. Bob Thacker, Bob Martell, Dan Baker, Laura Priest. And a cast of thousands bringing you Ashland High School basketball on WACA-TV. Tonight's game being played on December 29th, 2014. Feinberg the jumper, yes!
Max looking for it.
He really elevates.
Well,
Bob, he can get that shot off.
You're right, and sometimes because he has such good ups, he tries to use his jumping ability more than he needs to. You can't put a strain on your jumping ability. Go up 90% of what you can do. He's going to get clear.
Oh, nice move. Down the lane, up and in. And
all of a sudden, Leakey started to show a little offensive.
The up fake worked beautiful. Bresciani steps in but couldn't control it. Espinay is back in.
Rotations.
Steve Stupiello.
I think Hopedale's used 7-8 players, Bob.
Yes.
Ashland more than that, maybe 9. Another foul. Luke Cowan. That's his second. Chris Van Cleef to the line. We'll get to... get the bonus.
That's the way to do it.
And we'll be the double bonus next foul by Hopedale. Ashland's got 8 on their own.
This is the second. The ball's alive. Lynch tracks it down. Stupiello bringing it up. Steve is across the 10-second line. Leakey, no opening this time.
Nice help that time by Van Cleef.
Espinay. Collins open at the arc, turns it down. Lynch, Espinay, back to Cowan, has to take it. It's an air ball.
That's a good sustained defense. He had to force that one up, unbalanced shot, but he had to shoot it. Good defense by Ashland. Press, press, press.
Max
easily defeated there.
Mike down the lane, coast to coast,
Michael, nice individual move. The defense was very static that time. He found his way to the basket. They wind up having a foul. Bresciani's second. And that was a shooting foul anyway, Bob, but he'd be getting 2 anyway.
Swish.
Mike has the look of a pretty good free throw shooter. I shouldn't have said anything.
Yeah, that minimal amount of motion.
Yeah,
and,
nice and still.
Yep. 14-12, clock has trailed 2. Bresciani gets it back, wants to go down the lane, leads in, travels, no call. Leakey, Lynch, swish, it's a 3, our first of the night. And a 5-point Hopedale lead, the biggest of the night.
Kevin
Lynch. Lou Baker in the game, goes in strong, blocking foul.
NBA, that would have been a potential three-point, but he'll get two free throws anyway. Well, they score the hoop.
I don't know if he was pointing that as a basket was good or pointing to the floor on the floor, which they sometimes do, yeah. And they're not giving
they're
him
not
that
giving
two
him the
points.
Hoop, so he's got two free throws.
You know, my feeling on going to the basket, Bob, I don't really think you need to pay too much attention to the defender.
Yeah.
You know, go if he steps in, you know, he's going to get knocked into the back wall.
It's a natural
if he wants
human tendency.
Do that, okay. You know, and 80% of the time, it's a block anyway.
It is going to be a block. Yeah.
You know, so go hard and go right to that.
Okay, they
square.
They're now reversing themselves. They gave him the basket.
Oh, it's up there now.
The one free throw that he missed.
Because that requires an explanation now for Coach Cordani.
Sure. But the score is now 14-17. So they gave him the basket.
Now Francis LaVega is coming over.
That's a whoops.
Now Francis.
Yeah, they get a press.
He lost his free throw somewhere
what
along
happened?
The line.
What happened? So they give possession to Ashland.
Yeah. Holy cow. No foul on the play? It's not up there, is
yeah,
it?
They
gave him a foul.
And apparently after he missed the free throw, it is Max. Nice cut.
Ashland's cut the lead to one.
Interesting. Hopedale, who's very active, all of a sudden they got very static on defense. That was a nice cut and all, but that was very static defense.
Espinay, Lynch, Bresciani at the arc. They try to thread it in.
Ooh.
And Kevin was lucky there. I mean, what Kevin Bresciani, there was no hope of that pass connecting.
I think Mitch got caught on that foul, but you know what? That would have been a good off on Mitch, give the ball to Hopedale call. There wasn't much contact there, if any. Spencer Robidoux comes back in, Bob.
Bresciani, I'm looking at him as a more of a scorer than a ball distributor and playmaker.
Yeah, he's a hard-nosed player. I think if he's going to distribute, it's because he's been stopped going to the hoop.
Yes, exactly. Lynch. Kevin Lynch, a senior. Off to a great start here in 2000. In 14-15 season, that was a big part of last year's Central Mass Championship team.
Yeah, Hopedale, nice little town, Bob, just the other side of Milford. Pretty similar in size, I think, to Ashland.
Yeah, very small town.
And there's Max with a nice running right hander. That's a nice floating shot. Look to see, Max is a streak shooter and a streak scorer. He's getting the feel right now. He's got 6 points this period. Ashland still playing man.
Rabbit is in the game. Oh.
Touch, foul.
What, Francis doesn't have to do anything to be called for a foul.
He's that guy. He's big and physical, and they catch him on these little ticky-tacks.
Did he foul out of the Millis game? I think he did.
He may have.
Yeah. Nobody else had more than two fouls, and somehow LaVega fouls out, and I didn't see much there, but I guess, as you say, the little touch, the little push.
I don't know why. It's not like he's murdering somebody.
Yeah, and he's not bodying them up and in. A free 2 points gives Hopedale a three-point advantage as we go under 4 minutes left in the first half. Rabideau gives up his dribble, gets it to Max. Feinberg, the jumper way off, air ball. Whose ball is it? It's the Blue Raiders.
Max forcing his offense a little bit too much there. He was double teamed, and there was a backup player, almost triple teamed. Ashland gonna press, token press.
Espinay, a nice little move, couldn't get it to go. Van Cleef clears, needs help. Mike comes back. and gets it back to him. Good help there by Mike Boudreau.
Chris
over
there.
To Rabideau. Mike at the arc, doesn't want to shoot it, wants to take it in. Backs his defender. The fall away. Yes, Michael Boudreau.
Very determined that time. Nice basket. Head down, made a little space for himself. Finished in the lane.
I'm surprised no one closed on him from the other side.
He backed
off.
It was one defender and the rest backed off.
Yeah. Quick release. Wild shot.
That didn't look very smooth, did it?
Chris Van Cleef. Hits the clock as the lead.
Nice finish there. That was a nice breakout. Avoided the contact. Little slide move to his left. Very subtle, but very effective.
Been a long time since Ashland's been ahead, since it was 4-2.
I don't think they like to play from a head block.
22-21 with 2:20 to go until halftime. Oh, that was thrown up strictly for the foul.
Yeah.
He felt the contact and just released a shot so he could get a two-shot foul, although it doesn't matter at this stage.
That's his third, though.
Both teams in the so-called double bonus. Swish.
I'll tell you what, though. I'd rather see that type of foul where the offensive player has to earn it from the stripe. It wasn't just a hand-check foul. He contested.
Rabideau skies for the glass.
Tied up, Bobby, 22s.
Feinberg finds Van Cleef. Nice move by Cam Faniff, couldn't get it to go. Fight for it, whose is it? Oh. Questionable.
Max explained to the referee that it wasn't
looking for
him.
A replay.
This official has not made the Ashland team happy.
Brian Espinay, they get it back to Steve Stupiello, who I guess is your backup point guard when Bresciani's out of the game. Why not? No.
Surprise long shot.
Oh, he takes it down the lane, dishes to the arc. It's up. Sam Lawrence and one. 3+1. A chance for that rare four-point play.
He loaded up there, took his time, and drew the contact. Spencer Robidoux hustling over to try to block that shot. This is a potentially four-point play, Bob.
Sam couldn't finish it. He'll settle for a three
and a three-point Hopedale lead. You want to make those. That's like...
It's fun.
Hitting for the cycle.
Lawrence with a steal. Ahead of the pack. Up and in.
Makes that shot.
Sam Lawrence with five straight points. And a five-point lead for the Hopedale High School Blue Raiders. Going to Ashland on vacation week for a non-league game. Nice crowd on hand from both schools. Nice student contingent here for the Clockers. On a long, long winter holiday break.
Remember those? The winter break around Christmas from school?
Yes.
That was nice.
Yes. It was a pretty good feeling.
It was indeed.
As I recall.
We don't get those anymore. But.
No, although... I work today for the first time in a long time, it seemed.
Arlene doesn't need to know.
Mike Boudreau.
His ninth first half point, if my count's correct. Ashland back within three. Under a minute left, first half.
It's like Coach Cardani. Oh, Brian Espinay, the three, he felt it.
Well,
a couple of big threes.
Not afraid to heave them up, and that's their third three in this period.
Cam Faniff in the lane, pulls up.
Cam having a big quarter. 7 points this quarter, 11 in the game.
25 seconds, Ashland trailing four. Sam Lawrence, a bomb. Who's got it? Over the top.
Yeah, and new player in the game, Garrett Fishlock, gets in the scorebook, but it's a foul.
It wasn't brutal, but
yeah,
it was there. Yeah. He did not have the position. Faniff did. Ordinarily, so what? But yeah, when you're in the double bonus, that's two free throws.
Well, 17 seconds left. They're going to get a possession out of this, I guess, but I'm sure he wasn't thinking that. He was just contesting for the
Cam's got one.
Cam, his first point of the game. Ashland back again within three.
Kyle Booth making his first appearance of the evening. Kyle wears number 10. I'm guessing he's a defensive player. 17 seconds left.
Yep.
In there for his backcourt pressure. The clock is under 10. Espinay commits the offensive foul.
And Booth draws the offensive foul.
Great substitution by Coach Mark Champagne.
Good job.
Kyle Booth pays off right away. Clock is still have almost 5 seconds to see if they can tie this one up or take the lead as we go into the half. Faniff for three. Good if it goes. It doesn't. The Blue Raiders get the board and the half comes to an end. And a much better second period than the first period.
Totally different.
Hopedale 30, Ashland 28.
22 points for Hopedale that period, 20 for Ashland. They both had 8 in the first period, so apparently they decided to take off the mittens and start shooting.
Well, they warmed up maybe, huh?
Yeah.
Got that Christmas doldrums off.
Worked off the turkey.
Yeah, and that's nice. That's nice. And a great second half is coming up in 10 seconds. Stay with us. You're watching Ashland High School Varsity Sports on Ashland Television.
You're watching WACA-TV.
Well, back to begin second half action. Bob Martell, along with my sidekick, Bob Thacker. Oh, wait a minute. It's Bob Thacker along with me. First half scoring, Hopedale with 30, Ashland with 28. Sam Lawrence had 9 for the Blue Raiders. Kevin Lynch, 7. Brian Espinette, 5. Bill Leakey, 5. Y'all had five points in the second period, Bob, after being really challenged in that first period.
Of course, almost everyone was challenged
First period. 8 points for both teams in the first period. Max Feinberg heated it up in the second period, wound up with 8. And Mike Boudreau leads all scorers with 11 points, had 7 of those in the second period. Ashland trailing by 2 points, Bob, and if the first half is any kind of gauge for the second half, it'll be down to the wire, a lot of fouls, a lot of back and forth, two quick, aggressive teams here in the Clocker Gym. Back to our play-by-play, and Bob Thacker, the voice of the Clockers.
Anybody's game as we start the second half. Clockers trailing 2. Starting lineups for both teams look to be back in action. Leakey to Bresciani, who had a long rest at the end of the first half. Lynch, no. Didn't get set, didn't square that one up. Ahead to Paul Boudreau. Is that John Van Cleef?
Yeah, Mike Boudreau. You're right. It was John Van Cleef. Nice look there by Max.
Oh, Max had a good chance at that, but he missed the layup anyway.
A lot of action, but not a lot of results so far, Bob.
Mike Boudreau is 34, and Max is number 4. And Cam Faniff is 33.
Blew a tire there, but
John
regained
Van
the ball.
Cleef is 32. A 3. Oh, off the stanchion.
Yeah, hit the
a delayed call. So one ref was going to call it. The other didn't want to.
Yeah, let it play. Nope. Blow the whistle. Hey, watching the game, too, you pick up this vibe of Ashland. Doesn't really have a point guard. It's a kind of a hybrid look. They have 5 guys that can bring up the ball. That's good.
It is good.
Almost. Good defense. Good sustained defense.
Beautiful pass. And a nice, nice finish by Luke Cowan.
Luke Cowan, a nice little turnaround move.
Is there blood or jewelry or what do we got here? A sneaker violation.
Not sure what we're looking for there. Sneaker injury. Yes, and a little difficulty getting the ball in bounds.
Oh, boy. Leakey stole it. Bresciani for three, rolls around and out.
Yeah, Ashton a little lax there getting the ball in. Mitch had nobody to throw the ball to.
He looked open for a second, a delayed travel call on Mike Boudreau.
Picked up that back foot and tried to make it look like he was taking the step.
Very poor start to the game for the second half.
Yeah.
Kevin Lynch. Once again,
there's a step.
There's the call of the night, Bob, right?
Apparently, all the boys seem to want to get that little head start.
Last game against Mills, not called once.
Not called.
On anyone.
It's a call.
On either team.
Call of the night.
Do not wobble at all when you're holding the ball.
Max caught from behind, but Ashton lucky to retain the ball.
Camp Faniff.
And Faniff picking up the stuff off the ground and finishing. Nice move by Kim. Kept his head. Offensive accidental.
Cowan finally found a place to go. Couldn't get it to fall.
Kim, nice rebound.
Max ahead to Mike Boudreau. Oh, that's John Van Cleef.
Van Cleef, nice finish. Avoided the contact there, too. These Hopedale kids not afraid to go to the hole. They're pretty aggressive offensively, and these officials doing a nice job of letting them play a bit.
I like these Ashland forwards, Bob. I like the way they go to the basket, and I like their aggressive, poised style.
Well, they play like five threes out there. They're all playing aggressively and offensively, and they can handle the ball.
Mike Boudreau, Cam Faniff, John Van Cleef.
Bresciani, his first points of the second half. He had two in the first.
And Paul Boudreau.
Very aggressive player.
Here's Michael. Fall away. No. Yes!
Yeah, that sat on the rim just long enough and flew it in.
Tie game.
34-34. We thought it might be like this, and sure enough, a little different flavor than the first period, though, Bob. It's really opened up since then. Ashton staying in their man defense. And there's an unforced error.
Didn't see what happened there, Bob.
Looking, he thought there was an opening in the lane. He just overthrew that one.
Somebody wants a timeout. It's the Blue Raiders, I guess.
Probably not a bad idea for the coaches to start coaching.
First timeout of the game by either team.
34-34. Ashton came into this third period trailing by two. They've managed to tie it up. But right now, I think a tie means nothing, Bob. I think we're going to see a few exchanges of the lead as things go along. And uncharacteristic, too, there is no team fouls for either team this second half.
Well, thinking back to last year, I may have said that Hopedale beat Ashton last year, but I don't think they did.
I don't recall.
Clarkers were 19-0 going into the final game of the season. They lost the final game of the season. I don't know if it was at Norton or Bellingham or where it was.
I think they must have beaten them because they didn't play them in the tournament.
Right. Or, we lost in the tournament to a non-league team that we had beaten earlier in the season.
They just had one of those games when everybody, I don't know if they felt it or what, but the lid was on, and a game you expect to win. You still have to play the game. That's why they play the game.
They had beaten the team handily during the season. Of course, we can't recall the name of the team, but it wasn't a TVL team.
It was a non-leaguer. Well, Ashland heading west this half, downhill. It should be a little quicker.
Tie game, third period action. Bob Thacker, Bob Martell at Ashland High School. The Clarkers and the Blue Raiders. December 29th, 2014. Max off the mark.
Max looking for that up and under move. That's a tough move to make. You're down low, you're trying to move laterally, and you're aware of the defender, and it's tough to get the shot off, never mind make it. Max needs to let his offense come off the flow.
Yes, and I want Max to stop looking at the official every time something goes wrong. Three-pointer by Lynch is off.
First foul, second half.
Devin shoots on the fly those threes, and they just don't go that way.
Yeah.
If they do, it's by luck.
It's one of those plays you probably feel good about it.
Yep.
It feels good. They don't go in that often.
Yeah, you feel fast, you know, fast and loose. Espinay.
He's a pretty solid player. Not flashy, but...
He's got some height, Bob.
Yeah,
you know?
He's got a little bit of height. And
got some length. He looks to be the tallest guy on either team, actually.
Yes.
Yeah, he's about equal to Faniff, I guess.
Yeah, maybe he has a half an inch on
Yeah.
him. Yeah.
Uh-oh.
Foul. Yeah.
Mitch Porter says, what? It isn't on me?
Bresciani's third foul. And get him on the head. Those are the ones that even we can see.
Van Cleef is in for Spencer Rabideau.
One team foul apiece. And Bresciani's going to take a seat with three fouls. Going to rest him and protect him. Max into the backcourt to get that one.
Oh, Faniff. Blocked, I think, by Espinay.
Yeah, Cam had him beat, but just a little too much horizontal, not enough vertical to finish that.
Hopedale doesn't look completely comfortable on offense, do they, Buck?
No, they don't. John Van Cleef doing a nice job now. I think Hopedale, they play aggressive.
What a wild shot. Luke Cowan.
Ashland hasn't had that hot streak, too, Bob. They need to go on a little run. Give a shout out to Hopedale's defense, though. Here's Max out in front of the pack.
Go strong. Yes.
That's a nice finish. That's the way to finish.
Step in front of that.
Yeah. He's either going to get fouled or the basket or both.
And yeah.
Nice two, and we're tied again at 36. Oh. Little body that time.
Stepiello.
Nice little reverse move there. He's quick.
You know, he was determined that time.
Mike Boudreaux, his first foul. Ashland's second team foul. He'll shoot two.
Paul Boudreaux's into the game. Paul wears 34. Michael, his brother, goes out. Mike wears 22. I sometimes confuse them.
I wonder if they've ever switched jerseys, Bob. Get somebody out of foul trouble. Missed both. Stipiello hasn't a point. Done a nice job bringing the ball up, but he hasn't a point.
Boudreaux couldn't get it. Francis lost it.
Nice rebound, Francis, but get away from the left hand there. Ashton working the right side that time.
Okay, now we're going to see Bresciani and Stipiello in the game at the same time. I got to believe Paul Cardani is looking for a combination to click here.
Yeah, he wants to generate some motion.
Nice rebound, nice hustle.
Espinay, nice putback as he was falling down. Just crawled over the front of the rim.
John Van Cleef up and in. And John Van Cleef.
Nice reverse move. Determined move to the hoop.
I don't know what John's injury was, but he's come back very, very nicely tonight.
Shows no signs of wear and tear tonight.
He sat out the Millis game, and that was 6 days ago, so the rest did him a lot of good. Over the top. I didn't see any contact, but what happened?
Well, he tried to get around Espinay, and Espinay gave him a little right hand, and they called the foul on John Van Cleef.
38-38. Minute and a half left to go in the third period. Oh, his sneak away did not go.
Nice job by Chris Van Cleef that time. Good defense, good rebound.
Leakey had a great chance. Tightly guarded. Porter tightly guarded. That was a good idea. Pass was just a little long. Is that Chris Van Cleef had a great chance
nice
for himself.
Nice little look there.
Yeah, Luke Cowan can't get anything to go now.
Well, again, that thing you called out, Bob, anticipating contact. It didn't come, and he missed the layup. He's looking down.
Up, under, and in.
John Van Cleef looking strong around the hoop.
And motivated.
Nice finish. That's 6 points for him this quarter. And
Bresciani coast-to-coast to the dish. Locked.
Bresciani just, he hasn't figured that one out. Maybe the coach has to explain what traveling is to him.
You know, to me, that was one to finish.
Yeah.
And that wasn't one to dish backwards on.
Strange decision-making there by a usually solid player. Under a minute now, and Ashland has a lead again, 40-38, Bobby.
Chris gives up his dribble. Paul Boudreau went base and got fouled before the shot.
Won't be a shooting foul, but...
Baseline drive interrupted before it got started, I guess, is the call.
Luke Cowan's
Paul
third
Boudreau's going to inbound. Oh, he tried to go deep. Bresciani saw it all the way ahead of the pack. He goes in strong this time and ties the game at 40. 30 seconds until
all started with
the end
passing.
Of this period. Rabideau has it deflected away. 22 on the shot clock, 24 on the game clock.
And what a surprise, Bob. We're tied up at 40.
Clock has trailed two at halftime. They were tied at the end of the first period. Chris Van Cleef goes into the backcourt deep to Paul Boudreau. He's by himself. Brings it up. No trouble. Oh, that kid. The aggressive John Van Cleef couldn't get that one to go. It was too far under. Rabideau had it for the moment.
Oh, tell you, Spencer stepped in and had that ball. Foul from behind, though.
John Van Cleef wants the ball underneath, Bob. He was just too far under that time.
He does. He was doing good work underneath. Cam Faneuf could call for that one from behind. Could be last shot.
Oh, excuse me. That was Cam.
Yeah. Nice, Francis. Nice hustle.
Good if it goes. It doesn't. The third period comes to an end. Ashland 40 and Hopedale 40. 8 minutes left to play.
Well, Ashland scored 12 points that period, and Hopedale 10. This is a game of ebbs and flows. We'll see if the fourth period mirrors the second when they had 22 and 20 points respectively. Ashland trailing by a deuce at the halftime, Bob. Little comeback here. I tell you, 14 fouls for Ashland, 2 for Hopedale. We've got a few players with multiple fouls. Francis LaBega with 3, John Van Cleef with 3. For Hopedale, Luke Cowan's got 3. Kevin Bresciani has 3. With a period to go. And the way that first half had gone, I thought there'd be a plethora of players in trouble.
And once again tonight, our thanks to the Marathon Deli for feeding our great crew tonight. And they've been with us all season. They're on Route 135 in Ashland. And they have all the best for us, and they're big supporters of Ashland High School Sports and WACA-TV. And so thanks again to the Marathon Deli. All right, Faneuf is the 33. Van Cleef is 32. John, that is. And Paul Boudreau is 34. They're all out there with Feinberg and Christian Van Cleef. 11. Chris is going to inbound for the Clockers.
Ashland.
8 minutes to go. Tie game.
Ashland's sticking with the formula. Playing man. Hopedale playing man. Good basketball game.
Max trying to get the ball by cutting through the lane, but they can't find him. They go underneath again.
Why not do what's working? John Van Cleef to the hole.
He wants that ball.
And he's worked that left baseline very well, Bob.
Him and Faneuf.
Yeah, without Max having a monster offensive game, Ashland doing a nice job tonight.
Bresciani tries a 3 and the fall down. It doesn't work.
Yeah, that's
either
one
of them.
That's a flop.
Van Cleef dishes to Boudreau. Paul Boudreau.
Yeah, nice play all around, but Nice look there by...
Is that John Van Cleef?
Van Cleef.
Espinay. Asher with a four-point lead, their biggest of the game. Oh.
Timeout call?
Yeah.
All right. And
I'm going to say a good timeout.
Yeah, not a bad time to call a timeout. His team is a little bit fractured there, playing helter-skelter offense.
And pointless this quarter.
Yeah, Ashley, and that good man defense has paid dividends. Hopedale really hasn't had a lot of second shots, Bob, and that's been a key.
The Bresciani-Stupiello combination, the two point guards, I guess we'll have to say it did not work out.
Now, Bresciani does have 6 points on the game, but Stupiello has none. They're going to be offensively challenged. And you look at this score sheet, they've got 40 points. But really, nobody really has looked like a true offensive threat out there, where Ashley has had a couple of runs. And we talked about getting a run going. John Van Cleef, eight points this half, and he's been a monster going to the hoop. They haven't found an answer for him. I keep getting the ball to him, and things will open up for Max. He just has to be patient, and it'll happen.
Coach Cardani told me as far as scoring goes, it is very well distributed among his five starters.
Yeah, playing the style of ball where nobody's the go-to guy. Yes. I can see that happening. It's probably good distribution. I wonder what they're averaging per game.
All experienced players.
Yeah, they're aggressive. They're tough. They go to the hoop. I think that probably pays dividends. But you don't see a guy that you say, okay, when I got 5 seconds left, he gets the ball.
Yeah. Coach Champagne goes with the same lineup that finished, came out of that timeout, went into that timeout, I should say.
Still a lot of time left, 6:50 in the game.
Cowan, no.
Cowan, he's trying to light it up from the three-point line. They had three in the first half, none in the second half.
Max. Cam Faniff this time.
Hustle basket there. Nice job, Cam. That's it, Max.
Max trying to make something happen on both ends of the floor.
Good hustle. Refs don't like that, though. You need to walk away. Timeout, Ashland. Mark Champagne doing the same thing. He wants to get his troops under control. Ashland scored a hoop since the last timeout, so they're up 6 points now, Bob. So small sample, but
I would say Hopedale had a 5-point lead a couple of times, but I think this is the biggest lead the team has had.
I believe it is. It hasn't felt secure either way, but right now Ashland, I think. Exposing the offensive deficiencies of Hopedale with that tenacious defense they're playing. Hopedale really doesn't have a good look at the basket.
Yeah, no. And is it fair to say that Hopedale has forgotten about blocking out under the basket?
Seems like it.
And the Clockers are getting layup after layup after layup from their forwards.
Yeah, Faniff and Van Cleef.
Primarily baseline moves, not down the lane or anything, but...
Yeah, nothing from outside for the Clockers this half. They haven't needed to go to the jump shot. The only thing that's of concern is Ashland has 5 team fouls, Hopedale 2, and with this much time left, it might mean that Hopedale's going to the charity stripe. If they keep going to the hoop and the officials start blowing the whistle.
Same lineup for the Clockers again. Bresciani, he dishes. He was underneath. Sam Lawrence, no. Faniff with the position and the rebound.
Maybe not the most sound
Mike
strategy.
Paul Boudreau takes it into the lane, dishes Cam Faniff. Paul Boudreau.
Boudreau lost his dribble. Cam low to the ground, picked it up and finished. The forwards have been cleaning up for Ashland.
The bomb.
That weapon has not been there in the second half for Hopedale.
Lynch, very, very deep. Leakey. Kevin Lynch at the arc. Nothing doing. Bresciani, shot clock under 10. Lawrence couldn't get anything. Bresciani's going to do it himself. The Dipsy do blocked.
Yeah, he had nothing left up and under. Made himself even smaller.
Paul, ahead to Cam. Was it deflected? No, it wasn't.
Yeah, I think it was deflected Hopedale twice, though. But I think Chris Van Cleef hit it last, and fortunate for Hopedale. Ashley and not pressing.
Paul Boudreau gets a well-deserved rest. Who came in for him? I can't even see. Mitch. Oh, it's Mitch Porter. Yeah, 14. Bresciani. Nice inlet pass. Out it goes. Beautifully done. And now we're playing another timeout. Yep. We had no timeouts in the first three periods, and we've had three in the last minute.
And now the coaches have decided to use their toolbox and use the timeouts to try to coach their way either to a victory by keeping the lead or a victory by eroding the lead. Ashland's still up by six. That was a little gamble play there that William Leakey had the opportunity to do the finger roll and finish. I'll tell you what one of the things that's of benefit right now is if they're trading baskets, obviously Ashland doesn't mind that, but they're not also giving up fouls.
And it behooves Hopedale trailing by six to extend the game, so timeouts really help them clockwise. And they've got two left, Ashland with four left. Both teams get five for the game.
Early game today, Bob, starting at 5:30, so you'll be home for dinner.
Yeah, I'm expecting, a full meal just like a regular night.
I'm not sure how it happens, but I think we have leftovers at our house yes. Six, seven times a week. I don't know where they come from.
That could feed an army with the leftovers. Yes. And I think one of the purposes of this timeout I thought might be a full court pressure, but I do not see it.
No.
I thought they might challenge.
They
get
fouls
the
to give, too. I'm not sure why they're not. I know they're not as deep as Ashland, and they haven't been able to get any effect off the press, but I would be pressing a little bit.
Still a lot of time, as we're just under five. But, Faniff was where he wanted to
Travel.
Be. Yes.
Yeah.
And this referee really likes to call the traveling on the player on the ground.
Well, he didn't want to call a foul, which is a good non-call, and he had to call something, so that's a good call. Faniff
couldn't get it to go.
Yeah, could have called a foul there. He got hit from behind.
But Cam doing great work underneath, getting chances. You got to give him some attention,
yeah,
Bob.
Yeah, that inlet pass, you just, keep him with his...
Will Leakey is a handful, and another timeout. This one was Ashland's, I think. I'm not sure.
Yeah, you got to back him. You can't front him because he can't do anything away from the basket, so keep him from getting the ball inside.
Coach He's Champagne got two, obviously heard me and is making an adjustment.
Well, what he's saying right now is Bob Thacker said...
What does Bob think?
Yeah. He might even look over here and say, what do you think?
Giving him the thumbs up.
So, four-point lead for Ashland as the chess match continues. Eventually, they will run out of timeouts. They have five left between them. Ashland with three, Hopedale with two, and 4 minutes to play. So, that's about every 45 seconds we'll have a timeout. They'll use them up.
Hopedale's had the last 4 points, cutting an eight-point lead to four.
Well, the Ashland inside game is still working. They just... the officials haven't been calling the contact, but Ashland's still getting to the basket at will. Stick with that. And at some point, Max may be able to apply the dagger from outside.
Same lineup for Ashland that went into the timeout.
John Van Cleef right on the bench right now, taking a breather. But I'd like to see him back in the game. He's had 8 points this half. He's been a tiger inside.
Mike Boudreau, suddenly a point guard. And we see both the Boudreau boys bringing up the ball. Faniff outside this time.
Hope deals up there off defensive intensity.
They post Max, and Max takes a foul. I don't know.
Cefiello.
Yeah, he just kind of...
Yeah.
It was kind of a weird thing. He was going down and
Well, it's one of those aggravation factors, too, Bob. He was underneath.
Yes, he was low.
Yeah.
And I think Max was trying to post him, but before they ever got to that, it was a foul. John Van Cleef in his spot.
John, good patience, used his body well. A little bit of contact, not enough to create a foul either way, but made enough room for himself to finish that play.
It's a six-point Ashland lead. We're under 4 minutes.
And there's a
thrown away.
Nice step in that time, Van Cleef.
Ahead to Faniff, up and in.
And Kim, I'm not sure if that was a hesitation or just didn't have the handle, but it worked for him.
I think, was that from Feinberg? I think so, I'm not sure.
Nice pass.
The bomb, back rim.
Mitch, nice
Porter
rebound.
Steps to the rebound and takes the foul from Bresciani.
Hopedale now a little desperate, down eight. They had a foul to give just to stop the play there. But Bresciani is fourth. That's dangerous for him.
Yeah, it's not a good foul.
No,
I mean, the backcourt.
There wasn't really a break going.
No, what is the point? Against a non-shooter? Yeah,
at least go for the ball.
Oh, wow. Ambitious pass. Had the position, couldn't get it to go. The Clockers have the rebound. Max pumps it up off the back rim.
Good time.
Mike Boudreau doubled. He put it on the floor and he got bailed out by the foul.
Well, Luke Cowan looks like he picked up his fourth. And he should be happy that he gave his fourth, because otherwise it would have been on Kevin Bresciani. He would have been disqualified.
8-point Ashland lead. Max right away. Doesn't Ashland, use
no
any clock.
No need to hurry. Be patient. He was wide open. Had a nice look there. But that interior game is so effective right now. Well, let Leakey have it there. There's an offensive.
Wow. Textbook. Textbook play by...
Good draw.
John Van Cleef.
Good draw by John that time, although I don't think he could have got out of the way if he wanted to. William Leakey, a good aggressive offensive move, but he just buried him.
No complaints from Leakey.
No. He's trying to do what he can do, which is be physical and be aggressive.
No backcourt pressure by the Blue Raiders. 2.5 to go. Pull-up jumper. Max gets it to go.
It is a nice basket.
10 points is
facing
the lead.
The basket. He squared up, got up there, and that's the way he should operate.
Porter with token, and then the bad reach and
Mitch.
Foul stops the clock.
In this case, the clock is your friend. Let it run. Play good
they
body
a foul to give, Bob.
Defense with your feet.
So there'll be no shots,
no.
But there'll be free throws but from it, here on in.
There'll be a free throw with this one.
Bresciani sets it up. Down the lane, blocked, tipped out of bounds. Good hands by Mitchell Porter.
Yeah, that was close. That almost might have been tipped Hopedale.
Well, you never know. The reaction is sometimes you touch it and it's a turnover. Lynch.
Oh.
Deep backcourt to Bresciani.
Oh.
Bothered by Porter. Mitch good just, defense by Mitch.
Yeah, Mitch doing a nice job just to
Luke Cowan couldn't get that three to go.
Yeah, there's a push on Espinay from behind. That was very apparent.
He had a nice arcing rebound. I don't think he needed to do that.
No, but...
he didn't have the inside position, but they were so far away from the basket.
Yeah.
I think the arc of the ball was coming out where his height was going to maybe give it to him anyway.
Mike Boudreau had a nice arc, too, after he went up straight and then wound up 3 feet to his left.
Espinay's rugged, huh?
Yeah, he's a cute little ball player. He uses his body well.
2:01 to go in this game. Mike Boudreau trying to make it an 11-plus win. There's the 11-point lead, 55-44. Clock is by 11. One more for Michael Boudreau. He earned it by making that first one. Give him two.
It's the pair.
Bresciani goes behind the back. He's across the 10-second line. Porter's got him. Elbows to the chest. Espinay. Yes, and it's a three.
A three.
Timeout, Hopedale. 56-47, a 9-point lead, 147 to go. Espinay has had some big baskets
Raiders. He doesn't look like he should be a three-point shooter, but he's got two.
Let's see if they go to him here from the final 147, as everyone else has sort of struggled.
Yeah, he's got 12 points in the game and leads Hopedale in scoring. If you took the blind test on who's leading the team in scoring, would you pick Espinay?
No, and he's a player that came off the bench, but not a starter in either half.
Got 12 in the game, and you know that three is such a weapon, Bob. Even though Ashland's leading by nine, you see a play like that with more than a minute left, and you think, well, you know, it's only that many baskets. Hopedale still playing this, and they've got a lot of grit out there. I think we talked about this. There's a couple players in foul trouble. They may make it to the end without disqualifying anybody. But it was close.
Yes. You know, and I don't know if this is a coaching tendency or a player tendency, or, but in my observation, players on a team have a hard time going to the hot hand. It doesn't come natural to them. There's nobody, I guarantee you, there's nobody on that Hopedale bench saying, get it to Brian.
Yeah.
He's hot, including the coach.
Yeah. I don't understand that, too.
No.
I think
you have to tell them.
I'm a great believer in the hot hand.
Yes, me too.
Yeah. Likewise, Ashley.
I mean, it's evident to us, but for some reason, they will continue to run their offense as if he's scoreless.
Press break effortless.
He traveled, got caught up for just a second and shuffled his feet.
He did. He just didn't have a handle on the ball. Ran right into the pressure, right into the double team.
Just what Hopedale wanted, a turnover with only 5 seconds off the clock. Another travel. They
just walked and he didn't call that one.
Wow. Kevin Lynch very happy. Espinay, the fall away. Swish!
Espinay the man right now.
He feels it.
Yeah.
He's brought the Raiders to within seven. Clackers need a basket. Oh, who is it? Faniff had it in a pretty good spot. Max is going to elevate. Blocked. Faniff from beyond his range.
You know, they were so effective inside. All of a sudden, they're settling for jump shots. I'm not sure why.
Kevin Lynch, just not his night. Nice save. The Clarkers have the break. Mike Boudreau is tied up.
Oh, timeout.
And a timeout.
Good opportunity to push that time. I don't know if I would have called the timeout there.
There's only 50 seconds left. Clarkers leading by seven. Let's see what Coach Champagne wants his boys to do. Just three timeouts left, two for Ashland and one for Hopedale. 50.6 seconds, I think, is what I saw on that game clock as Ashland went into that timeout.
Well, if he's been watching the game like we have, Bob, I think what the formula has been is those forwards down low have been very effective. Give him the ball.
One advantage to the backcourt timeout is you get the 10 seconds all started again from the backcourt.
Yeah.
Not that they use that many seconds getting it up.
I was going to say, all those times we said they'll manage the clock at the end of a period or a half, I don't think we've ever seen clock management like that.
I've never seen a stall.
No. I don't expect to see it here either. But if Ashland plays
I used to go into the Harlem Globetrotter.
The weave. We haven't seen the weave.
I would actually whistle Sweet Georgia Brown at the end of the game.
In those days, you had the huge hairdo. You're saying here, a little breakout.
Max has got it. It's across the timeline, takes the foul from Lynch. And a good free throw at the line. And let's see, is it a one-on-one, Bob? It is.
Yeah, one and one.
Make the first, get the second. Big spot for Max and the Clarkers with 46.8 seconds left in this tilt. Oh, a clutch swish.
Good free throw shooter normally, and especially down the stretch.
How's he done tonight?
He's 3 for 5.
That one goes off the rim. Ashland with an 8-point lead coming up on 40 seconds left in the game. Way off. Air ball. That didn't bother Leakey. He went and got it. Lynch misses another three. Espinay up and in.
Espinay gets away with another little push. Very cute little move there. That's a six-point game with 30 seconds left. You just can't crawl in the box, Bob. You got to keep playing your offense. 18 fouls for Hopedale, six for Ashland.
Two-possession game.
Two-possession game if you want to count it in threes. But Ashland, the clock at this point becomes very important. As we said, here we go. Timeouts left for Hopedale, none. Ashland, two, as they use them all up down the stretch in the game that should be over. We should be heading for the exits with a W. We're sitting here with 30 seconds left.
Must have been an NBA game, but I think the last minute of an NBA game took a half an hour recently.
And they shut off the beer concession, which isn't right.
Half an hour for 1 minute.
They should add an extra beer for every timeout left.
Ashland's got an inbound successfully from under their own basket. There's 31.3 left in this game. Clock is protecting a six-point lead. They're going to have to make some free throws, Bob.
Yeah, they're going to get fouled, and Hopedale's going to press, and they have to take care
of
business.
Go for the steal here. They don't get the steal. They continue to play D, and the Clockers are across the 10-second line. One pass, too many, maybe, but he'll shoot two.
Yeah, it would have been nice to see John Van Cleef go strong to the hoop there. I think he would have drawn the foul. But the one extra pass, he's looking for the freebie. They got the foul anyway, and that's...
And they burned 10 seconds, Bob. That's, you know?
Yeah, Espinay, who was their force in the fourth quarter late, fouls out of the game. That's a big deal for Hopedale.
Nobody else has been able to buy a basket.
No, he had seven fourth quarter points. Came a little short on that one. Six.
I have to say, letting those 10 seconds go off the clock and letting Ashland bring it up all the way to the basket,
yeah,
and then ending up with a two-shot foul. They missed them both. If they had done that with 33 seconds left.
A little different.
Yeah, a little different opportunity.
Yeah.
Of course, if you're going to drive and throw it away, I mean, what difference does it make?
No, you have to hit everything when you're in that situation.
Yeah, Bresciani's got the ball. You know, he's the ball handler. He should be able to, he has to be create an opportunity for himself, even if it's a three-pointer.
Well, I don't want to say fatigue, but the kid played hard all game long. He played virtually the whole game, fouled out just a second ago. And I think that played a part in it. I think when push came to shove at the end, he was exhausted. And other than Espinay, they really didn't have an option there in that fourth period.
Espinay looked like he could get his shot off because he could elevate on a jumper.
Yeah.
And I think... Bresciani's size works against him a little bit.
Yes, yeah. Well, Adolph Rupp at Kentucky used to say, when your 6'6 jumpers get tired, my 6'11 guys will still be 6'11.
That's right.
Max makes the first one.
That makes it the three-possession game. With 11.4 seconds left, Max misses the second.
Uncharacteristically,
the rebound goes to Lynch.
Shooting 50% from the free throw line, but...
He pops a three. He doesn't get the roll as he has it all night. And this time it's just going to expire underneath the Hopedale basket. And a great win for Ashland here tonight. They beat the defending Central Mass champions and the undefeated Hopedale Blue Raiders. The final score, Ashland 58 and Hopedale High School 51. Another great win for Ashland. Just like they did in the Millis game, they showed guts and determination.
Yeah. They showed
down the stretch.
Showed depth. They showed tenaciousness, and they did what they had to do. And in a night when, and I hate to say, Max was offensively challenged because he wound up with 14 points. That's not much of an offensively challenged night, but he did struggle a bit. They didn't need him because the big guys up front did a heck of a job.
Paul Boudreau, Cameron Faniff, John Van Cleef, and Michael Boudreau. What did they combine for?
I'll add it up in a minute, Bobby. I'll give you that in a sec.
We'll be back with the postgame show in 10 seconds. Stay with us. You're watching Ashland High School Varsity Sports on Ashland Television. Back out here at Ashland High School for the Ashland High School Varsity Basketball postgame show. Another great win for the boys tonight as the Clockers hold off Millis. Come from behind to beat Hopedale tonight, 58-51, just like they did on our last broadcast with the Millis Mohawks, Bob.
Yeah, early sample, Bob, but patterns developing here. This is a team that just wears other teams down. They throw 9-10 players at you. They've got some interchangeable parts. Like we said, they don't have a point guard. They've got 5 point forwards, a lot of threes out there, and interchangeable parts that can score from inside and outside. Max Feinberg had a little trouble getting it started offensively tonight. Still wound up with 14 points, but you could tell he was not in his rhythm. Actually, when he shoots 50% from the free throw line, that's uncharacteristic for Max, who's usually very reliable. And yet Ashland, at the end, pulled away to an 11-point lead and then hung on to win by 8. Nice victory tonight in the gym here on a kind of a mild night bordering on the new year. As we get the old year out of the way, Ashland walks out of the gym with a W and goes to 3-2 on the season.
Nice to knock off the Central Mass champions from a year ago, the Hopedale Blue Raiders, and they were undefeated going into tonight's game, and that's gone as well. And Ashland goes to 3 wins and 2 losses here on the young 2014-2015 season. The Clockers, I'm trying to think, did they lose? I think they lost their first 2 and have won the last 3. So they're heading in the right direction.
Which is good. Hopedale, you could tell too, Bob, well coached. A lot of hustle, a lot of confidence. Teams that have been there, they know how to play the game, know how to win. They're not the most talented team offensively. As you said, good point distribution, but that's because they get their points off the offensive flow. I'll give you a quick summary. Sam Lawrence had 9. Kevin Bresciani, who wound up fouling out and playing the point, and tenacious defense, a very physical, aggressive player, although small of stature, wound up with 6. Kevin Lynch with 7. Brian Espinay, who wound up carrying his team in the fourth quarter, had 7 points there, but 16 on the game. Most of them in the second half, 11 in the second half. William Leakey, not a gifted offensive player, but a real gritty player, did a nice job and wound up with 9. And Luke Cowan wound up with 4 points on the game. For Ashland, Max Feinberg with 14, Francis Lubega with 2, Chris Van Cleef, who did a nice job at the point and played some good defense, wound up with 3 points. Mike Boudreau, a nice first half, had 11 in the first half and 4 in the second for 15. John Van Cleef, who almost the opposite, 2 in the first and 10 in the second, lit it up in the second, wound up with 12. Cam Faniff, same thing, 2 in the first, 10 in the game. And Paul Boudreau rounded out the scoring with a pair in the second half for a total of 58. Just nice distribution.
So
7 players scoring for Ashland.
So between Paul and Mike,
yep,
and Cam and John Van Cleef,
yep,
how many points did those four have?
Well, the big guys between them had 39 points.
39 out of
48.
58. Right?
58, yeah. Excuse me, yeah.
And I guess Max had the rest,
Max,
pretty much.
Max,
yeah.
Francis had a pair, and Chris Van Cleef had 3.
So the Clocker defense and the Clocker inside game tells the story tonight. A great win here at Ashland High School, 58-51. Max with big free throws down the stretch to make sure Ashland didn't have to worry.
Yeah, very entertaining game, Bob. It was close for most of the game. Like we said, 2 well-coached teams. They had at it tonight.
It's home, nice to beat a good team.
Yeah, nice to beat a good team at home cooking. Ashland walks out of here on the holiday with a well-earned 58-50 W.
Although both teams, all teams still feeling out themselves and the opposition. Hard to tell who's going to emerge in the TVL at this early stage.
Just sorting out.
Of the seasons.
Yeah.
And,
yeah.
But there's many more games to come. Boys and girls basketball, Ashland High School ice hockey, wrestling. and track,
all the
and swimming, yep. all the winter sports yep. coming your way right here on WACA-TV. So last but not least, the Bob Martell player of the game.
How about this? Since we talked about interchangeability, how about those big guys, Mike Boudreau, Paul Boudreau, Cameron Faneuf, and John Van Cleef, all had big games down low. And that's what turned the game around when they started going to the hole in the second half. Hopedale didn't have an answer. So the four big guys tonight, four stars.
Impressive performance by the entire team, and especially those four players. Their tenacity and their poise and their aggressiveness, very, very impressive here tonight.
Yeah, nice team victory. This was a great team victory.
The Clockers win it. More to come right here on WACA-TV. Stay with us all season for Ashland High School Varsity Sports. We want to thank our great crew tonight with Adam Halperin and Laura Priest and Dan Baker. And for Bob Martell, I'm Bob Thacker. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.
Happy New Year.